In the previous video I converted my ZoneStar 3D printer into a plotter. The next step shown in this video is to modify the mechanics again to use it as a dot matrix printer. The difference between plotter and printer mode lies essentially in the software. Plotters draw lines from a starting point to an endpoint, while matrix printers create a graphic line by line, setting points in a fixed grid. Thus, the difference between vector and raster graphics can be nicely illustrated with the ZoneStar. With the plotter upgrades of my 3D printer, the machine also works as a matrix printer. Here I use a permanent marker that creates dots with a diameter of about 4mm. The rasterization can be clearly seen in the graphic printed this way. The image template consists of 60x37, so a total of 2220 pixels. Only the black pixels of the bitmap are printed, here using a green marker, which is still 376 pixels. At each of these pixels, the pen must be lowered and raised again. The Z-axis of the printer is driven by spindles with a pitch of 2mm, making a total of 5 revolutions for a stroke of 10mm. With the acceleration and maximum speed set here, painting a single dot takes more than 1 second. With 376 pixels to process, a total time of more than 6 minutes is needed only for lowering and raising the pen. The entire printing took about 8 minutes, there must be a way to speed it up somehow. The first thought was to set the pixels using a relay and utilize the fan control to turn the coil on and off. The relay moves a piece of wire that dips into a paint reservoir up and down. This works in principle, but there is a disadvantage. Without modifying the firmware, it is impossible to control the relay with a really stable and high frequency. In a previous video I demonstrated the functionality of a self-built printer using a relay. The approach I'm using now is much simpler. I changed the lowering and raising of the pen on my existing plotter mechanics, for what I only had to print 3 additional parts. Besides 2 pieces of 4mm threaded rod, a second quick-release fastener for the Teflon tube of the filament feed is screwed in at top of the new component. The pen is now lifted through a lever. To prevent the lever from moving too far downwards, I have added a stopper. The lever is driven by the extruder motor. When the filament is fed in, it presses on the lever by what the pen goes up. When the filament is pulled back, the pen goes down, following gravity. Due to the leverage, moving the filament by only about 4mm is enough to raise the pen by 15mm. If the feed rate of the filament is increased, the pin can be dropped and raised about 4 times in 1 second. In order to make the filament really move, the hot end must be heated up to at least 170 degrees Celsius, otherwise the firmware will ignore any filament feed commands. The second version of the lever is slightly wider, giving the filament strand a larger hit area. The new mechanism for raising and lowering the pen speeds up the plotter mode significantly as well. In the previous video, the plot of my colored maker took about 20 minutes. Now, the plot is completed after 11 minutes. In matrix printer mode, the conversion also results in a clearly shorter print time. The graphic shown at the beginning of this video is now done in just about 4 minutes. Anyone who has ever used a 2D printer knows, The higher the resolution, the better the printed graphics. Here I'm using fine markers that put dots in a 1mm grid. The 69x83mm graphic consists of 69x83 pixels, which is 5727 pixels in total. During the first pass, the 2382 black dots are set. You can see that the areas are not uniformly covered with color because the dot diameter is smaller than 1mm. The graphic is built line by line from bottom left to top right, same as the data being stored in the bitmap file. A Perl script translates the color points of the underlying bitmap into G-code commands that the 3D printer, now acting as a 2D printer, can handle. More information about the software can be found on my pages. During the second pass, the machine hammers the orange dots on the paper surface. The pen is lowered and raised 807 times. It can be seen that the tip of the marker has already suffered minor damage from hammering on the paper. A soft pad under the paper to be printed will extend the total operating time of the pens. The final color to be printed is blue. Here only 22 dots for the pupils of the penguin are added. The job is done after about 10 minutes. The grid structure is clearly visible. The graphic has the charm of the early days of computer technology. I definitely like it. In the next print I increased the pixel density. The graphic now consists of a template having 122x146 pixels. I have also reduced the grid pitch to 0.6mm, giving it about 42 dots per 25.4mm, equivalent to 1 inch. With the smaller distance, there is no more free space between the individual points, areas are evenly colored. In black color the printer sets a total of 3981 dots in this high resolution mode. The orange pen is hammered 2571 times on the paper for this graphic. The speed of this printer is not exorbitant, you can watch the line by line construction of the graphics extremely relaxed. This is not a mass production machine, the teaching and learning effects are in the foreground. Finally, the blue pupils of the penguin are printed with a total of now 80 dots. If you enjoy watching machines doing their work, you will love this dot matrix printer. By the time the last dot is set, 27 minutes have passed. The first result is TUX in draft mode. The dot matrix and grid pitch are clearly visible. It can also be seen that the orange dots don't fit exactly into the dot matrix of the black and blue pens, the areas are slightly shifted downwards. Reason for this is, among other things, the bent tips of the felt pens due to the hammering on the paper. This offset can be corrected by software. Inkjet printers perform a calibration routine after cartridge replacement for similar reasons. The TUX in high resolution is much clearer to see on the paper surface. However, the printing time was much higher and more ink was used. Hammering on the hard surface has another negative effect. In particular, the ink of the orange pen has spread so-called satellite drops on the paper. How matrix printers work is still evident in the graphics even in high resolution mode when having a closer look, I like it. Besides paper you can print on many other surfaces as well, here I've prepared the printer to colorize a t-shirt. For the graphic, once more I'm using the large markers with permanent ink in a 5mm grid. The ink is definitely not perfect because the dots frazzle on the fabric, this is just a first try. The glass tile is inside the t-shirt and it is mounted with printed clamps that raise the glass for 20mm, so that the rest of the t-shirt fits underneath. In order for the pants to still fit under the park pants while printing, I also had to raise the mount on the upper frame. In the 3D files of the printer I've modified the mounts so that the 10mm nuts I'm using as spacers are not needed. Anyone being more talented in creating graphics than I am, and this is for sure the overwhelming majority of mankind, can dive into dot painting with this machine. As usually, the files for the conversion of the ZoneStar 3D printer and the software I'm using are available as download on my pages. Thanks for watching and I'll be back.